a future. Arguably, Delta State remains one state in the nation that has embraced the education of its citizens with so much commitment, to the extent it has one of the highest numbers of tertiary institutions in any Nigerian state.
A lot has been done in the school setup, a lot of monitoring, a lot of engagement. We're engaging a lot with all the higher institutions. Most of the polytechnics are doing very well now. We are preparing yet again for another set of accreditation. We're hoping that we'll do well in those sets of accreditation. At the university, the Delta State University, a lot has been achieved. Within the time we've come in, we've been able to get accreditation for the law faculty they didn't have before, full accreditation for the engineering faculty, and full accreditation for the medical sciences. All these three key areas we've been able to get within this last 2 years because of the renewed focus on how things should be done and the way and direction we need to go.
The Ministry of Higher Education, the supervising ministry for tertiary education, was created on 14th of October 2005 during the administration of Chief James Onanefe Ebori, who was governor at the time. This was done to give adequate attention to issues concerning tertiary education in the state. The question is, what role have these institutions played in preparing young Deltans for life?
Beginning from the Board of Technical Education, which is a regulatory body, MBT says whatever we are doing should be 70% technology based and 30% for others. And the polytechnics had before today, in their own ways, complied with that directive. That means that a lot of our students who are there in the polytechnics will begin to see a lot of these things that we have been taught to them theoretically come to them live. You get to the workshops, so you have mechanical workshops, you see these things running live. You go to electrical workshops, wood workshops, and all of that. In its sense, wealth creation at the end of the day would be achieved. They'll have their skilled knowledge, and they're also going to create wealth. That is giving life to the vision of His Excellency the Governor.
Smart Delta Media Quest to bring credible and first-hand information on the Governor Kowa-led administration's intervention in tertiary institutions in the state took us through an odyssey to the schools. Our first port of call was at the Delta State Polytechnic, Uzoro. Our meeting with the registrar, Mr. Samuel Onaiberi, was quite revealing as he revealed to us the efforts of the Okowa-led administration to reposition the ivory tower to produce well-rounded and grounded graduates who can compete globally.
There's an ethics and standard committee put in place with its terms of reference. Is to ensure due compliance with labor regulations as far as teaching and learning are concerned. It's part of our effort to see that we maintain standard to justify the resources that the state government is actually expending on the polytechnic.
Mr. Onaiberi also applauded the administration for rebuilding decayed infrastructures, as well as articulating policies that have given the school recognition by the relevant bodies. We were also taking on a guided tour of the chemical and mechanical departments with different machines on display for practical lessons procured for the school by the Okowa-led administration.
This administration have done a lot to this very department. We have a lot of machines that have been provided by the administration. They feel at home when they do practical with the lectures they receive.
At the mechanical engineering workshop, we met Ogenkioja Ogenerume and Utu Emeogene, who are students. They appreciate the government for making provisions that have aided study and made schooling fun.
This present administration is trying their best to put up good environment for students to learn, and I really appreciate their efforts As you can see, we have a lot of machines here. We have the lathe machine, we have the welding tools and the rest. We should sit up tight, study well, and see that Delta State as a whole and the country as a whole should not fall or go down during our time.
We learn only the theoretical parts. It's not really understanding. But when you come to the practical aspect and seeing all these machines, it's easy to understand it. When we're done with the school and going to future, we'll be able to use the machine properly. Like, it won't be something new to us. We'll understand it and be able to use it better.
At the Chemical Technology and Analytical Laboratory, Acting HOD Mr. Opo Samson and some students of the department hailed the government for making education practical and skills development oriented.
Government has actually purchased some equipment for the department for the takeoff. Among some of these equipment, we have the heat transfer apparatus that was used to conduct experiment for students for heat transfer between two surfaces. We have so many other ones for distillation purpose.
Provision of the equipment has helped because of, in terms of practical, we've learned to do things that we should do in the industry. We've learned to do them here.
The government has really tried for us. Some of the equipment we have, most schools don't have it. And it's aided us to learn more and it gives us wide knowledge.
It is also worthy of mention that Governor Kowa was at the Mechanical Engineering Department to see things for himself not too long ago.
So if there is any place that is not proportional, not in alignment, we accept it through the morning.
Come to Delta, Delta, my Delta.
Come live in Delta. Come invest in Delta. Come explore the potentials of our state.
Going over to the Polytechnic at Ogara, Deputy Rector Mr. Joseph Nana chaperoned our team round the institution, pointing out government's intervention that have changed their story, making teaching and learning a worthy experience.
Welcome to Delta State.
You are welcome.
A state peaceful and well secured.
You are welcome.
We feel with hope and promises.
You are welcome.
A state where talents are born.
The Entrepreneurship Development Center was well equipped for students who are into trades and craft. Aliyu, Tunji, Uti and Princess, who are students in the department, are thankful for the opportunity of having a rounded education.
After my school now, when there is no job, at least I already know how to sew, so I can just continue from then.
This is what I dream to become a fashion designer. I will try to work hard to achieve my dream.
After learning fashion and designing, you can employ yourself by opening a store. When you open a store, God also will be bringing people that will come and work in your hand. From there, you can achieve good success in fashion and design.
What I'm doing now, I enjoy doing it. I feel relaxed doing it. Like, I'm just having plan for this fashion design. It's not everybody that have the opportunity to have money and go outside and learn it. But they just gave us a free opportunity. We say big thank you to you, Governor.
Smart Delta Media team was also taken to the welding and machine workshop. Here, we saw quite a number of machines for engineering studies. Engineer Tikpakpa Augustine, who is a lecturer in the department, was happy the state government understood the need to move with the times to lay emphasis on practical studies.
You know, our days, we don't have those type of machines when we are in the higher institution. But now we see new machines coming out. The youth of this period, when they work with those machines, at least they will be grounded technologically.
From Ogara, we veered into Mosoga to check out what was on ground at the College of Education, Mosoga. A chat with the provost, Professor Emmanuel Ejeme, reveals that the institution had undergone changes, including a change of name from the Delta State College of Physical Education to College of Education, which is now a full-fledged academic institution in 2015 by the Okoa-led administration. Professor Ejeme noted that government intervention has been spot on, with regular payment of salaries and building of a new 300-bed hostel, among other developments.
Without the state government, we won't have this school. So we want to use this opportunity to commend the state government for the intervention it's doing here. Our staff are regularly paid, and also we receive some monthly intervention to assist the smooth management and the running of the college.
So having a hostel here will help us to be able to save transport and cost and all that. Because most people are coming from Warri, some from Koko, Ogara, and Saple and different places.
Because the new thinking and emphasis is now shifting to entrepreneurial and skills acquisition, he reveals that the school curriculum has been tweaked to accommodate such training.
The state government has a smart agenda which emphasizes a job creation and wealth creation, employment generation and all that. In line with that, our college is introducing, by way of keying into it, a Center for Entrepreneurship Studies and Development that will create a platform for training of prospective participants in the program in the areas of skill acquisition.
It's a very good step in the right direction. In the sense that because in Nigeria, you see, there are a lot of persons who are out of school and there's nothing to do. If this is done, it will help reduce the dependency level in the sense that people will not longer stay at home, but it will help them on how to get something doing.
Down with Mosoga, College of Education Warri beckons. Here we met the provost, Professor Mrs. Mary Adema. She tells our crew that since Okowa took over the reins of governance, the school has been in good stead with regular payments of salaries, ICT compliant, and also that lots of courses have regained accreditation.
His interventions have really had an impact in the school. Salaries are paid as at when due. We have never had to go 1 month without salaries being paid. And because of that, you'll find that staff wranglings have been reduced to the barest minimum. So we are really grateful to His Excellency for that singular act.
I would like to commend His Excellency, Senator Dr. Ifeanyi Okowa, for bringing in this initiative. Students are becoming entrepreneurs by this initiative. I'm in this department to acquire a skill so that when I leave school, even if there is no job, I can see how something doing.
I give a plus one to Okowa for bringing this skill acquisition into our school. Most of us don't know how to sew. I'm actually enjoying what I'm doing. Thanks to our teachers, thanks to the provost, thanks to Okowa. Thank you very much.
Welcome to Delta. My Delta, my Delta. Welcome to Delta. My Delta, my Delta.
Come live in Delta. Come invest in Delta. Come explore the potentials of our state.
We do that.
You better run, come to Delta State. Come and see the good things where Okowa he they do. You better run, come to Delta State. Come and see the good things where Okowa he they do. I see a job and wealth creation in Delta. Make the youth say them highlight.
Okowa.
I see good roads everywhere in Delta. Make the people say them cola. Empowerment for the farmers in Delta. Food and quality education in Delta. Well-equipped hospitals here in Delta. I have business security in all the grounds. Come live in Delta.
Let me tell you.
Come invest in Delta.
But I tell Nigeria.
Come explore the potentials of our state.
Let me tell Nigeria to the man.
Come live in Delta.
The chant has it again.
Come invest in Delta. Come explore the potentials of our state.
Then we'll chant at it again. We'll chant at it again. Delta.
Much more than people are willing to give credit, food and dietary habits form a critical and fundamental part of our everyday health needs. To keep Deltans healthy and groom professionals in the paramedical and medical support services subsectors, such as laboratory technicians and others, the state government set up the School of Health and Food Technology at Ufuoma Ogeli. Though it predates the Okowa-led administration, it has, however, had plenty of input by way of upgrade of facilities and policy rejigging to make the institution run optimally and efficiently. The Chairman Governing Council, Dr. Nelson Ejakbovi, who took us round, proudly informed our team that one reason the Center of Excellence stands out is that all its courses are accredited by the relevant authorities and that the school is digitally compliant with an e-library that boasts of at least 30 computers, courtesy of the Okoa-led administration. At the Nutrition and Dietitian Department, we met students in their practical session, tinkering with baking and some other foods. Head of the smart media for the day, Mr. Amechi Udemba, had a bite of some delicious cuisine. He was joined by the chairman.
Start with you see, and you can see, yes, it looks very delicious. Let me have a taste. Clap yourself, clap yourself.
A chat with some of the students revealed that they are quite happy that facilities in their school have been upgraded. The like of Amaka Enua, Victory Vokali, and Irimoni Oyenetega expressed their gratitude to government for repositioning higher education in Delta State. They talked about their experiences as students, as well as their hopes and aspirations for the future.
As it is like this now, we don't put sugar when doing it. Why people in our side put sugar?
With this knowledge, when I live here, without government work, I can be self-employed by doing this.
I've learned so many things in this department. How to make liquid soap and how to make donuts and cake. It's self-employed, and the Nigerian economy does not have work today, so students here can get employment through the things they bake.
Looking through the physics and medical laboratories, dental clinic, ICT computer pool, nutrition hall and others, we chatted up lots of students and lecturers whom we discovered their experiences differ, but nonetheless pleasant, as they all hail good organization and government's positive intervention to change the face of tertiary education in the state.
Before I came here, I never knew how to make use of the computer, so without phones and other things, I will not be able to do my assignments. But now I can dash into any cyber cafe, handle the system myself, and I'm able to operate it.
We come here to teach ourselves more, enlighten ourselves more about the computer and its units, because most of us didn't actually get the chance when we are at home. So this helps us to get a little bit of knowledge about computer, which can help us even when we are out of the school.
Most of the graduates from here, they can fit in most of all the maybe federal paracelsus and the HMB state medical centers, where they can fit in some of the labs, where they carry out experimental practicals.
At the community health demonstration room, we discover that students here are trained on how to take care of health needs of children. They also embark on community sensitization on global good health practices.
If you get some, if the picking temperature is high, you can still do it like this to cool the temperature. Then you can carry a big bowl of water, soak it with sorrel, and use it to press the baby body for the temperature to cool down.
Our major work is preventive work. In the field, we go and mobilize the community. We tell them about preventing measures so that they will not get sick. If we prevent diseases and sicknesses, people will not go to hospital.
At the College of Education, Abo, the good reports of government intervention and provision continues. For instance, the provost of the college, Mr. Joseph Ukadike, insists that government's policy on entrepreneurial and vocational studies is one of the best decisions taken, as the development of skilled manpower is critical to the overall growth of Nigeria's economy.
Apart from the academic certificate we give to our students, we have equally embarked on entrepreneurship and skill acquisition to our students. We expose them training. People are learning fishery, we have all this agricultural, this animal husbandry, and we have confectionaries. We should be able to give them certificates in addition to their NC or degree certificates they are going to get from us.
For Mr. Lucky Chukunyem, coordinator of arts education, funding of trainings for lecturers by government to better equip them for the task of teaching is a winner any day and should be sustained.
There is what we call on-the-job training. Our lecturers here, including myself,
I am on training, seminar attendance, conferences attendance, and the rest of them. You should endeavor to support the institutions. Education is such that we should always look forward to going higher and higher, because it is the only long-lasting legacy we can bequeath to our children.
The experience of studying could not have been better, according to Mekunye and Efrune, who are students. They say a well-stocked library and equipped laboratories will always be students' delight.
To the state government, I would say thank you, because having made this possible for many students to be admitted into schools, that's a very good one. Our classrooms are okay. Lecturers are doing their best. You know, they've done a very nice job. We're grateful to them.
Government has actually made the learning process in this school easy and fun. Like my own department, we have a lab where we want to do our phonetics and phonologies. We go to the lab, we have this headset connected to some systems, so we use it for learning, thereby listening to the sound that we're being taught and getting the real sound from it. And we have a library where you go and find whatever English book or works you're looking for, whatever work you're giving, you go there, search for materials, and as well read.
Delta State University, Abraka, Ole, and Anwai campuses have all had their fair share of government interventions, like the Senate building in Abraka under construction, the law and engineering faculty in Ole campus, and others on Anwai campus.
This building, as you have seen, you know, has added value to this faculty. In 2015, we had an accreditation visit, which we failed because we didn't have a befitting faculty complex. And in 2016, another team came. And I want to say, without fear of contradiction, that they were really amazed at what they saw. They didn't believe that between that short period, what has happened, you know, has actually happened. So such interventions, when they come, you know, as at when do, you know, they help to, you know, get the system, you know, moving. It's not only in structural intervention. We have people also who are going out for further studies.
It is also worthy to mention the library services that complement tertiary education. Also, the scholarship board, as well as adult education, which takes care of the older age bracket that may not have had the opportunity of regular schooling.
For this edifice you are in now, it has put in place so many things that can boost education in Delta State. We're connected with internet connection. We have the e-library section. We are subscribed.